So, Vas, with your dry suit experience, obviously now you're diving one all the time.
Sure.
You're putting it on and off almost every day.
Sure.
Have you got any little tips, techniques people can do to improve or make it easier to put a side mount system harness on? Because they are custom fit harnesses and obviously they're a bit tight. You know, I find it myself, it's quite difficult sometimes to put it on.
There's really sort of two broad things. One is the sort of sequence that you do things in, and the other is the actual procedure for donning the harness.
Mm.
So I think the one of the important things is not to have anything on your wrist when you put the harness on. So computers, compass, wrist slates, go on after you've put the harness.
Right, so leave them down the bench.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I think the second thing then is that if you think about the traditional way that you put on, say, a BCD, a harness, it's just like a rucksack, isn't it? Where inevitably one arm's going to go in and the other hand is going to kind of try and come around the back and find something, and inevitably you're going to pick up the crotch strap and not the shoulder strap. When you put your hand in here, maybe it goes in between the two loop bungees, maybe it goes below and not above,
or through one,
and it's all happening behind you, isn't it, when you try and do that. If you then add to that, let's say, ring system on the suit, it's now even harder to place yourself. So I actually don't do that anymore. What I'm doing instead, it's going to make a bit more sense when we look at it on the video. But I'm starting with the idea that I've got a dumb valve on my left shoulder. So this is the arm that's going to go in first. But I'm actually holding the BCD in front of me. And what I do, I have a technique where I'm crossing my hands first and I'm supporting the weight of the harness with my right hand. So my left hand is clear to go through and I can visibly see a nice big hole. So no argument, that's gone round. Then when I lift the unit above my head, I'm switching hands now. And I've now created this giant hole on this side now that I can see it. I've got my hand and I'm going straight up and through it. So clearly I've placed it correctly. And once it's here, I can pretty much let go. And the harness will just drop into place with my arms straight above me. So I don't have to have super mobility in my shoulder. I don't have really the same problem even if I'm wearing a ring. So it takes a bit of practice to do it. The hand crossing thing, you know, which way around does it go? And we'll show you a little bit later how that actually looks. But I'm doing it all the time. Because I always used to catch the hand and the shoulder. And I think there was a time when probably after a workout with you, having hurt the shoulder a little bit, and you actually don't have that same level of mobility. So that was really, you know, what I came up with.
No, it's good. It's good, yeah. And you got me trying it as well, and actually it was a lot more simple.
Sure.
Yeah, once you worked out how the hands cross and then what changes to what, for sure, it's easy.